I remember when the OBREZ pistol first came out in the CTE, I checked the thing out. I knew it had high damage, but I didn't like it at all. I wasn't getting kills with it. I thought it was junk. I didn't like the reload time. Let me tell you guys something. This might be the best secondary weapon in Battlefield 1 right now. You know what? You might be like, Rumspanker, what changed since the CTE? Well, I was playing it even more after the CTE once it released, maybe about a month or so ago, and I really started to realize there's certain things I needed to do to get better with the OBREZ pistol and absolutely wreck the enemy with this thing. So we're going to get into in this video is I want to share that with you, just 5 tips to help you guys destroy the enemy and get better with the OBREZ pistol. Now, that being said, before I even get into this video, I'm not going to get into the history of the weapon. I'm not going to get into unlocking it tips because I've handled that already in a video. I'll post a link in the description below showing you guys that stuff. We're not going to get into that. All I want to do right here right now is to get into one of the, or actually the most powerful secondary weapon, and I'm even going to call it a melee weapon. You're going to be like, Rumspanker, it's a pistol. I'm calling it a melee weapon. I'm going to tell you why in a minute. We're going to get into why this thing is so powerful, how you can use it effectively, how you can get multi-kills with this thing at one time, take out multiple enemies at one time, and how you can just wreck with this thing and use it as a melee weapon. So let's get into this video very quickly, guys. For what you came here for, right now we're talking about the OBREZ pistol. Let me tell you something. This pistol does some serious damage. So in close range, you can get up to one-shot kills in about 5-meter range. One shot. You're just destroying the enemy. Reload. Just shoot again, you're destroying the enemy. So there's 5 things that I want to share with you that I think will really help you, that aside. So, number 1 is the crouch slide. When you're using the OBREZ pistol, you're going to realize you have 5 ready to go at any time, right? As long as you're fully loaded, you got 5 ready to go. As soon as you fire your first shot, there's going to be about a second, maybe a second and a half. I'm not sure exactly how long that reload time is, but you have that reload time to worry about, right? So what do you do during that reload time? Do you stand still? Do you stand there stiff as a board? No. My first tip to you guys, I've mentioned it before in previous videos, get used to crouch sliding. Get used to moving around. You move whatever you can do. During that split second, during the time that that thing is reloading, if you haven't killed an enemy, if you haven't killed them with that first shot, you need to move, duck, dive, dip, dab, whatever you can do to get out of the way as you reload that next bullet. That's tip number 1. So if you're not already crouch sliding, which that's what I tend to use. If you're not already crouch sliding, just try to duck, try to move, do anything you can. Do not just stand there. And then there's a caveat to this first tip when I go into melees. That's going to be our 5th tip. Now, tip number 2 for this, what you want to do is let enemies come to you. So for example, right, you see enemies, you shoot them, they may still be alive, they're coming at you, there's a distance, there's great distance between yourself and the enemy. Usually with a secondary weapon, what I find, you know, a lot of players do is they start to engage the enemy, they start to leave cover, they start to shoot at the enemy. With the OBREZ pistol, don't do that. This pistol does such high damage, such absolutely high damage from very close quarters. So the closer the enemy gets to you, they're actually digging their own grave. So what I love to do is if I fire the OBREZ pistol, and let's say I got an enemy who's like medium range and I don't kill them, what I like to do is I like to back into a corner, hunker down, I just wait, I listen, I wait for the enemy. As soon as they turn that corner, they just dug their own grave. Let the enemies come to you. Do not get in the habit, don't treat this like other secondary weapons. Don't get in the habit of you fire your first shot, you miss. Don't get in the habit of charging out towards the enemy to close that distance. Get yourself behind cover, let them close that distance, and let them dig their own grave. That's tip number 2. Number 3, to get multi-kills, and I've been getting tons of multi-kills with this weapon. What you want to do is, let's say you're taking on multiple enemies at one time. So what you want to do is, let's say there's an enemy to your right, an enemy to your left. What you want to do is, first of all, before you even get into that position, before you even get into that bad situation, what you want to do is stay close to cover as much as possible. The reason why I say that is because with the OBREZ pistol, since you do have that delay, while you're reloading, that delay in time before you can load up that next round, what you need to do is be ducking behind cover, you need to be finding cover, you need to be staying out of the enemy's sight during that time. So if you are surrounded by enemies, what I love to do, since I've already stayed around cover, you're not out in the open, you're not out in the open with this thing, hopefully. What I like to do is to stay behind cover, and then I can take out multiple enemies at one time. So this is how I do it. You might be like, Rumspanker, it doesn't make sense. Well, this is how I do it, right? So if I run into a building and I see an enemy's chasing me, that's already one enemy that I have to contend with. But if I see an enemy inside, then I try to duck into an area where the enemy that was chasing me cannot see me for a moment while I take out the other enemy. Then I contend with that enemy, and I do the same, so on and so on and so on, for however many the enemies are there. I think during this part, I'm going to play right here a clip for you, just showing you me taking on about 5 or 6 people at one time. time, because I'm able to do that because I just treat each person. I make it a 1v1 situation. Even though there's multiple enemies surrounding me, I make it a 1v1 situation by keeping myself only visible to the player that I want to attack at that one time. So tip number four, guys, as far as the OBREZ pistol, hurry up, keep moving, stay on your feet. But take your time with those shots. You're gonna realize, once you start using this pistol, you're gonna realize there's a lot of muscle memory involved with this thing. You're gonna be wanting to take a lot of hip fire shots, which are pretty effective. I highly recommend, for the most part, do most of your firing as hip firing. But what you wanna do is hurry up, duck behind cover, you wanna crouch slide, you wanna duck, move, dip, dab, whatever you wanna do. But then as soon as you pull up those sights, kind of give yourself a second to relax. Make sure that shot is on target, because if not, all that movement you did is for nothing. Because remember, you've only got that one round where you have to reload again. So like I'm saying, hurry up, but take your time with those shots. So a lot of times I'll be dipping and diving and dipping and dabbing, and then all of a sudden I'll just pull up my sights, or I'll just hip fire, but I take that extra split second to make sure my sights are directly on the enemy. And now my tip number five, guys, for helping you pwn, wreck, destroy the enemy with the OBREZ pistol. And this is probably, forget all the other ones, this is probably the most important: melee in close quarters. This thing is basically a melee weapon. The reason why I say that is because this is what happens, right? When you fire at an enemy with the OBREZ pistol, you are most times, 9 out of 10, going to do about 90 damage to them if they're within medium range. If they're close range, you probably already killed them. But if you do about 90 damage to them, as soon as you go to melee them, I don't care where they are, as long as you're within melee distance, you are guaranteed a melee kill. So this OBREZ pistol will actually support the melee. It actually will help you to get more melee kills, believe it or not. So what I highly recommend is, if you're in very close quarters, you fire at an enemy, and for whatever reason, they do survive, and they're still breaking the distance with you, they're still close with you, go immediately to the melee. Guaranteed you will get that melee kill, guys. You're actually gonna be surprised how much melee kills you get. I mean, there's been times where I'm just slapping people with a shovel. Like, I mean, it's just ridiculous. So hopefully these tips help you guys. These five tips that I think really helped me, because when I first tried out this OBREZ pistol, I was like, man, this thing is junk, trash, garbage truck juice. But then I really decided, you know what, to hunker down and actually check this thing out, and I'm so glad I did. So I hope these help you guys out. All right, hit that like button if it helped you out, please, because it helps me out. All right, guys, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button. We're on the road to 3,000 subscribers, man. I think we're getting pretty close. I think we only need like a couple more. So thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch you on the next one. It's your boy Rump Spanker, and I'm out of here.